let me tell you something, America. Cole Bishop's gonna run all over these scrubs out here in the challenge today. I'm not taking any bums. I'm knocking out all contenders, and I'm coming. I'm gonna finish my milk. I'm gonna eat my Wheaties. I'm gonna go home, and I'm gonna say my prayers at night, because that's what a champion does, and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm coming, and I'm bringing home the title for you, America.
Take it on, all contenders. Cole is not so much, and I will eat his Wheaties after I win, because that's what a champion does.
Glad to be a part of the show again. I don't know if I'm exactly prepared. I am doing the quite opposite of staying in shape.
Nick Ernie.
Probably gonna lose. not really looking for the W today, just looking to have fun.
I don't know if anybody here, I don't know their skills or anything like that. I mean, you know, Jorden, he's a pansy. Dan, he's also a pansy. Look at the bicep right there.
Right, I'm Mahoney, pretty much, and these guys have way too much energy.
I got my secret weapon here. 5 hour energy. Oh. Tastes like shit, but the shit's legit.
What's up? Obviously, I'm Brad. Ready to, fucking take my pussy money weed?
Nah, I think it's gonna be a good day. I'm interested. I'm here to see what this is gonna be like.
Obviously, with my face, I'm pretty.
So I'm about to go rain on some shit.
Oh yeah, you didn't even tell the camera you had stitches.
Yeah. I'm gonna tear the stitches out of his leg with my teeth.
Hi, I'm Scott Allwood.
Hey, Tony G.
Tony G.
This is the Extreme Vicious Challenge. Vicious Challenge Extreme version.
The way this show's gonna work, we're gonna split you up into two teams of four. So we're gonna get two captains to kind of choose those teams. They get to choose their own team. But to get those captains, we need to do a little mini challenge to see which one of you really deserves to be a captain.
You're gonna run up the slide. Then get down off the slide however you want. Zigzag through the swings, and then climb on the top of the monkey bar, and then jump down.
And you'll also be wearing a wig when you go through it, by the way. That's the extreme part of it.
If you drop the wig, you have to start over to the last section.
Yeah. We're gonna take the fastest two times. Those two people will be the captains and decide the teams. On your mark, get set, go!
I didn't really go as fast as I probably could, but I didn't really care. I was doing it more to show them how to do the obstacle course.
Time.
But I think I probably got the worst time on that, but oh well.
Hey, that hair will match.
Go!
I went, if you notice, and I hope you do a replay right here as I'm saying this, I went around the poles, and there's poles over there, like, in the middle. I made it more difficult on myself. I would have surprised the tires. I know I'm not. I got about 5 hours in me.
That was warm.
I felt good going through the swings. Then I got up on the thing and fell.
Oh God!
I laid there, didn't want to fall down all the way. It'd be super embarrassing. So I just continued my way over it.
In all honesty, when I was running it, I didn't want to be a captain. Too much responsibility. It was all right. I just almost broke my foot when I jumped off the hunky bars. That's fun.
I thought you were actually supposed to put your foot on it, but mostly everybody was just putting their hand on the rails. I could have won it, but it wasn't really a big deal. It was just for the captain, so it doesn't matter.
All right.
I saw there was a couple good times, so I figured, why even try?
I got on top, and I really didn't know my plan, and my feet just hit the sidebar, and I just slid them across as I went. Worked out perfectly.
Eagle, yes, master.
Lucky I got to go last. Saw the obstacle course, how they did it. I glided through those swings. I was. Finally, Dan showed me the best way I thought possible to get across those monkey bars. Not hitting the rungs, but sliding your feet across the pole.
The German judge gives it a 3.5.
I broke my heel. Winners of the Captain Challenge and are going to be your captains. Dan, with 16 seconds.
Just pure athleticism. Plus, I got to go second to last. Pretty much just all the planning I needed. Killed that.
And Jorden with 15 seconds.
Hello, viewers. Captain. Knew that was happening. Did you guys? You guys should have seen it coming.
I wanted it bad. I wanted to be a captain.
Me first?
You got the fastest time, so yes.
It all came down to who I had to choose. And my best thought process was, I want people who have been here before.
Cole Daddy Stevenson.
Cole Daddy Stevenson.
Because he's fiery red. He's ready to go.
First pick's cool. I've been getting first pick all my life. You know, kickball, whatever.
Cole Big Kai. And I got Kai. He's a wrestler. He's athletic.
Kaizo.
I was hoping for Jordan's team. I don't know. Dan's pretty cool, though.
Tony G.
I know I give him a lot of shit, but he's fucking strong. He picked up Folks and carried him across in fucking one season. That was crazy. I did not think he was getting him up. Plus, he does wrestling. He's in shape.
Tony G suck.
Oh, yeah.
Yep, basically Jordan's team stacked like usual. I was like, come on, pick me. Come on, I want to be on that side.
Brad. Yeah, pick Brad, just because he's been in the Vicious Challenge a couple times. He knows what he's doing out there.
I'll get you on the last pick up, Brad.
Mahoney.
Oh, that shit, huh?
I'll take Mahoney.
Oh, you will? Thanks.
I really just did not want Arnie. I wanted to beat him.
Arnie was the last pick. Steel, but he was the last pick.
And I got picked on the team that had Jorden and Kole on it already, so I'm like, yes. Other Vicious Challenge people that kind of know what to expect.
Congrats, awesome to me, because Jorden and team always seems to win.
The only thing that can make you better than anybody else in these kind of games is being in one before and knowing that you can't expect anything, because you never know what's going to happen.
I have three rookies. It turned into rookies versus veterans, and I was like, we're gonna have to show up, you know, because they know what they're doing. We don't know what we're doing. Well, at least I don't know what I'm doing.
Each mission, you are in teams, but you aren't working together as a team. You're all for yourself. So if we're in the challenge and you win that mission, there's one person going to be winning. Your whole team wins, but that person is the winner of the challenge. They get the money. If you guys lose, the whole team, they go into elimination together to try to stay in the show. The person with the lowest score time in that elimination will leave. The first mission, each one of you is going to be blindfolded, and I'm going to set up a little area for you all to stand in. I'm going to put 16 little army guys in this area with you. You have to find that army guy and hold on to him. You have to find as many as you can. So at the end of this 2 minutes that you're going to be in there, whoever has the most in their hands is going to be the winner of that challenge. You just have to have them in your hands.
All I want to say is I know
when we
this
talk,
is...
Can we talk to while we're blind?
All right, guys, they asked if we could talk. I thought it'd be kind of fun if you couldn't.
He said we could run. I said anytime you feel anybody come up on you, if you can touch your hand, I thought. You want to do a whistle or...
We can grunt.
There could be a cigarette over here.
You guys ready?
No.
Oh, okay, just let me know when you are.
I'll do it on you.
Alright.
Okay.
I would not want to be blind. Fuck being Daredevil. Blind sucks.
I didn't think it'd be that hard, but as soon as it went over your eyes, threw everything off. I tried to memorize where I was, and as soon as you put it on, I just had no idea where anything was.
Don't look at me like that, Mahoney. Come on.
Ready.
Alright. 3, 2, 1, go! Hey, you're out.
I thought you dropped something behind me, so I turned off in the wrong direction, and I hope you play a replay of me doing that right now. I hope you got me doing that. But I went the wrong way, and...
Okay. And I was, like, feeling around. All I felt was grass until I felt someone's foot and someone's hand in my chest.
So I grabbed a twig. I thought I had one. So I was excited. I was like, all right, I'm probably winning. And then I grabbed a big one and realized that it wasn't, so I just threw the twig away.
I expect like little, you know, little stick figure things, the little tiny ones.
The blind challenge is terrible. It's awful. I don't like that feeling. If I ever go blind, it's suicide immediately after.
Every time somebody touched me, I'd roll. I did a little lineman roll. I tried to stay out of their way. I tried to fucking not get any army men taken away from me.
I didn't get a single one. I had to take them away from people.
No talking.
I wasn't gonna fucking try to wrestle anybody for some fucking, that's, I don't know, a little bit too gay for me. Like, I'm not finding any. How am I supposed to find any more if I keep getting tackled? You know, it's just frustrating, so.
Catch somebody.
Well, once I was blindfolded, I tried opening my eyes, and my long, beautiful eyelashes got tangled in my eyes. So I'm sitting there, I was very uncomfortable.
You're going to Shikai, turn back.
Pretty much, whenever I touched anybody, I just tried to go in the other direction, stayed away from them. I had a bunch off the start, so I didn't really want anybody around me.
Somebody attacked me, I don't know who, I was blindfolded at the time. I wrestled my way out of it, got out of there, and hightailed it a couple of yards away.
Someone's tickling his feet.
And, oh, look, I found an army man. So I'm, like, fighting for it, like...
30 seconds!
I'm like, this is mine now, motherfucker. And then I found out it was someone on my own team.
Found out it was my own team? Yeah, that was not fun. Very disappointing.
Thank you. How
are we fighting each other?
It was going fine for a while. I mean, I found a couple of them and everything was going good. And then, I don't know who it was, Mahoney or somebody ran into me and just... I went like this, hold on to them. They all just broke into a bunch of pieces. And I'm picking up arms and legs and heads. And it was all right. It was fun.
3, 2, 1. Mahoney, you little bastard. What are you trying to pull over there? Oh, yeah, that was nice of you. All right, you're done. Take off your blindfolds. Mahoney got the most guys. Him and his team wins.
I got the most legs.
Mahoney's blind wasn't all the way on, I think, because he got a lot more than he should have. He's got little arms. There's no way he got that many.
We get in the first challenge, and I proved my worth on the team. I went ahead and won that blindfolding. Some crazy shit.
Mahoney kicked ass. He said he found the jackpot right away. That's good. I don't care. He can have the money. He needs the money. All I care about is a team victory. We don't go into elimination. They do. That's the plan. We stick to a team. We'll fight for it all at the end. Tell them we're brothers.
That was nice. I enjoyed that challenge.
So, I'm pretty disappointed. But what can I do? You know, I was blindfolded.
It is cool. We're going to win. These guys, I don't think they have anything on. Usually when I say that, it's bad luck, but I mean, elimination's coming, so.
Alright guys, here is the elimination. Not everyone's going to do this at once, the losing team here. You're going in there. It's going to be two people at a time. What we're going to do is, there's a bunch of trash in my back seat. We're going to...
my car.
And then, we're going to spin you around 25 times, then throw you in there blindfolded. And there's six things you're going to be looking for. So you have 30 seconds to look for all these things. All right, there's money, there's Nerf darts. Those are both worth a dollar, or not a dollar, but they're both worth a point. All right, so you can grab as many of those as you want, but you have to keep everything in your hands. And then there's a lei, you know, like one of those things they do in Hawaii. It's worth 5 points. There's bottles in there, a bunch of random soda bottles. Those are 5 points each.
Bottles or things?
Bottles. There's a big toad in there. Worth 20 points. There's only one of those. And then if you guys can find Waldo, another 20 points added to your score.
I do not want to be eliminated. I'll be very upset if I get eliminated. I'm going to cry a little bit maybe on my way back to the truck and I'm leaving.
All ready? Spin.
5, 6. I'm trying to make you not fall down. You just sit in there.
23. All
right. I was dizzy at like 10. And then I was stumbling around the rest of the time.
You just sat in there.
Ow, shit!
Boys, ready?
You weren't really too dizzy once you got in the car. It kind of calmed down.
Go!
Just grab and feel, you know? That's my favorite thing to do anyways.
There was nothing in any hidden places in that car, except for at your feet. And I wasted about 20 of the seconds looking everywhere else.
I was going just to grab everything, but then I thought, no, just be precise and technical with it.
Done!
That's it. Hands up.
How am I gonna put my hands on the drop of the
chair? I mean, hands where I can see them, I guess. Got 2 points. 3 points. 18 points. Red. He's got the 3 bottles.
2.
15.
Well, I heard that it was 5 spins.
what was that, 19 spins later, I felt like throwing up.
Well, I mean, I felt secure in your arms. I knew you were going to spin me out of control. It was nice.
And Mark's like, oh!
The last thing you mentioned was the Waldo book, and all the trash was on the ground, and you're like, oh yeah, and there's a Waldo book. I just went straight to it.
And then you said go, and I just grabbed every fucking bleeping thing in there.
He started to come over to my side of the thing, so I just threw my whole body like this and just blocked him from getting to my side of the car.
I felt the bottles, and then I felt the feathers, flowers on the way. And I just kept them, and once I found the toad, I felt the toad, so I just hunched over in my little corner of protection until the ride was fucking over.
And I had like 10 bottles in my arms, and I felt one can, and I went to pull it out, and I dropped all the bottles on the ground.
Time!
Time?
Yep, hold your shit.
I told you specific things to grab. Grab a bunch of trash.
What are you doing?
Somebody found Waldo.
Is this a toad?
Yeah,
that's a toad.
Nice.
Nick got 36. He got more than I even want to count, like 50 points. Kai got 18. Brad,
you did get 15 points.
That's pretty much how a champion plays.
Hey Cole, guess who's not going home? Fuck it, bitch.
Look at that.
Thanks for coming out. Sorry, Brad.
Always love seeing him.
But, I mean, other than that, it went good. I'm still in. So, as long as I ain't got to run, should be fine.
Anything you want to say to your fans out there?
Well, what's new? Nothing. Goodbye.
That was one of your fans reaching out to you. I didn't know if you got that. It's kind of hard to get without seeing.
I'd like to meet that one.
Yeah?
Not just his hand.
Isn't it last?
Oh, yeah, much love to you.
Do it, Cole. It's too many. Cole, it's too many. Don't do it.
You still have the timing on this?
Oh my god! A lot easier, ain't it?
Oh, look at that.
No! Oh my god, damn! We're that close to have stitches in your hand.
I don't know if you noticed, but there's a whole blue team over here. Two red guys.
Oh, Kai, you can't meditate.
Kai, I'm...
Jorden, catch.
Oh!
That was not me!
Alright guys, the second mission is a team mission. We're going to have one person start. We're going to whisper them a number. This person's then going to crawl to the next person, and they're going to whisper that number to them. That person's then going to roll to the next person, who is then going to eat a package of ho-hos. When they eat this package of ho-hos, then they'll write down the number, they'll yell done, and then we'll repeat the process 5 times. Each team will go separately. Fastest time wins.
We're just going to slide your extra person in there. So like say that second person has to roll the rest of the way to get to the table. They're going to just tag somebody in the middle, and then that person will roll the rest of the way. All right, so if you guys miss one of the numbers, it's a 5-second penalty. Each number you miss, it's a 5-second additional.
Kill.
First number, 1-4-7-6-9-3-2.
I started off crawling like a madman, and the numbers were no problem. I remembered all of them, gave them to Cole, no problem.
So I was rolling and then I messed up. Oh, golly shuck. So whoops.
Cole, you're about to hit a tree.
Jeez, how embarrassing is that? What a fucking jackass do I look like?
Over here. I hear it.
Well, we lost a little time there. It's all right.
You gotta find this man rolling at you.
Got it. All right. Sweet. Good rule.
Finally gets to you, get a fucking long-ass number thrown in your head.
1-4-7-6-9-3-2.
This whole time you're sitting there repeating this number in your head, You gotta find the bench, crack my knee once, made it over, and then you gotta pull out the ho-hos, which by the way, were slightly melted. After I get done stuffing both of them in my throat, like it was the last ho-ho on earth, I still have to remember this number. Are you crazy? I'm sitting here repeating this number, trying to chew. I can't do this.
Good.
Got it!
1-4-7-6-9-3-2.
Dan! My knees are all tore up.
And my first roll was kind of bad. I was really lost for about, I don't know, 10, 15 seconds.
Eating, it wasn't that hard. I mean, I watch a lot of eating competitions, so I was prepared mentally and physically.
Okay.
Go!
And after about three numbers, I'm like, all right, that's about enough. My knees are starting to hurt, and then we still had two more numbers to go.
5556551.
So I think I started slowing down a little bit on about the fourth, fifth crawling point. I did what I needed to do, and the rest was up to my team.
I'm sure it was a lot funnier than it felt. I just kind of got dizzy and kind of felt bored half the time.
Kole definitely had some problems rolling away. I couldn't see it. I heard it. Heard about it.
Kole.
Barely didn't know. I didn't know I was fucking about to go knee deep in Ass Creek over there. You know, I thought I was dead center and I was blind and I had no sense of direction. And I started crying.
Oh. Hey.
All right, Jorden.
But I had a kind of small job. Just had to roll, remember a number. Wasn't too bad.
4 5.
Yeah. 6 5.
4 5.
4 5.
6 5 2 1. 6 5 2 1.
6 2 1.
So 5 5 5 5. 6 5 3 1. But after I get done eating these melted Oreos, your hands are just covered. Your mouth is fucking cotton out because you have all this chocolate in your goddamn mouth. You're sitting there trying to lick your fingers down. So I mean, look at my shorts here. This fucking chocolate just from rubbing my hands because. Couldn't open up the packet. I have this slippery chocolatey grease on here. Looked like fucking a baby at a fucking big old buffet who had pudding. I had fucking chocolate all over my mouth, and my hands, my shorts.
Saw the other team going.
We were just kind of excited when they started saying one number.
7. 7? Yeah, just play down.
I'm not sure if you got confused with that, but...
Oh, 7. That's it. Just write that down. That'd be cool.
We didn't really think that the penalties would be as big of a problem if we didn't get all the numbers right. So we just kind of went through it as fast as we could and hope and prayed.
Hey, right here.
Go, there ain't no remember now.
No?
No, go.
Dan.
Just write down a number.
We don't remember.
Oh, shit.
My main problem was opening it up. Not really remembering the numbers because I got like 7 and 8 and just write something down. So that wasn't that bad.
10 and 9. But a W on the scoreboard.
That's like 15 seconds, dude. You're like 45 rolling around the street.
Yeah.
15
seconds.
It's five seconds.
Per number and letter.
Per
what?
Number and letter.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
You said it was 5 seconds.
Each number.
We did not know.
Each number.
You didn't say that to us.
How does it feel to maybe win on a technicality?
That's fucked up.
That's the rule.
Only one number, though.
Okay, done.
You know, we can sit here and argue about this all day long. The fact of the matter is, you guys
still
going
home before me.
You're going home right now. You're on
Asian
time, motherfucker.
Yeah, it is Asian time.
You are done. That's it.
You're about to be
Nada. Done. The Vista. You're done.
Oh, yeah.
Get
you're
yeah.
done.
Get
you're
out.
Out of here. Oh, yeah. Yeah. You suck.
7 right here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
My boy right here.
7.
Oh,
yeah, get his
yeah.
ass. Get his ass.
Get up.
You
suck.
Yeah.
Get
up.
Yeah.
Get up. Get up.
Out of here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Get up.
You're done.
You're gone.
Elimination.
Get up.
You lost.
Get up.
You.
When you apply this look.
Are. This is out here.
Yahoo. Is that?
All right, guys.
All right, next down is cross.
I do have the results. Okay, the first team had a time of 14:07.
No way. It is.
And then they had 25 seconds added to that for penalties. It's 14:32 altogether. The other team had a time of 9:45.
They still lost.
And then they had penalties of 2:15. They got 11:60.
Ah!
The red team does lose.
Now, I'm sure that's right. How do we have 14 minutes?
Because he rolled for 3 minutes,
suck.
Dude.
Lahoo Zaher. That's why you have 14 minutes.
Because Dan's the king of rolling.
And that's why we're the fucking champions.
I was actually so confident that we won. I was in, Cole and I were in their ears. We were just in their ears calling them losers, saying they suck. Talk about foot in the mouth.
The most embarrassing part is between Jorden and Cole talking all that shit afterwards, and then they come that round and they lose. It's like, man, whatever.
They just made a mockery of this thing that you love, and I love, and I'm pissed that they won, even though they did that. You should have just said, you know what, fuck you guys. You're not going to take this game that I sat up all night with. You know, you're out of here. I don't want anything to do with you right now. Can you believe that? Can you believe these guys?
We sat here and, you know, they talk a lot of crap, but we got the W, so. Thumbs up.
We get to watch the elimination round.
Who's going home? Tell me who's going home.
Cole's going home.
I go into elimination now, and I do what I always do. I win. Because I'm not going out before Dan does. It ain't happening. I might cut my thighs if I fucking lose to Dan. That's all I'm saying.
Find out what's about to happen in this elimination. I think Cole and Jorden just think they're going to walk on through the rest of this. So we'll see. We'll see.
Now I got to go into elimination with 3 veterans. At first I was like, all right, I'm on a team with all veterans. But now I'm in elimination with 3 veterans, so it doesn't really help me.
And I heard at the beginning of this is still a singles event. You just paired up with some roommates. We'll call them roommates. Who hasn't liked a fucking roommate? I don't like any of my roommates. I have to live with them, but I don't fucking like them. So basically, all I know is I'm coming out on top. I would really like to see Mahoney go. Oh, he's kind of like an injured deer out there with that wounded leg.
All right, red team. This is going to be your elimination. You will be blindfolded.
Yes.
We are going to set a football at a spot,
we know,
at a destination. You're going to start over here. I'm going to say go. You're going to run out to that football. You're going to try to grab that football. You're going to bring that football back. Look. Like, just bring it back, and then you're good.
Yeah.
And then the next person, and then when there's that last person, that sounds good. We'll put Kai on flute duty.
Where's the flute?
So now you're Katrina? Kytrina?
Kylie.
Kylie?
All right, so we got in this elimination where we had to be blindfolded and pretty much ball wrestle between our team. And I'm like, oh boy, some of the best Vicious Challenge competitors are going to be going against me in a ball wrestling mission.
When you hear the flute, run to the ball. On your mark. Mahoney has got the ball back.
What's going on?
You're safe.
That's how that is done. Right there.
That's what I tried to do. Hit him.
That's Kylie.
Way to hit a girl, guys. Come on now.
Bring the flute. Bring the flute. Play where it's at. Hold on. Stop. Don't move. I'm gonna give you 15 seconds to get out of this. If not, we're gonna start over.
All right.
this.
Wow. Who's gonna talk shit and lose now?
Oh well. Championship slips in my fingers again.
Get some water in that system, boy.
Well, I wish it wasn't you.
Huh?
I wish it wasn't you.
I know, dude. I was thinking the same thing.
You know, the other guy, and I would have been happy, but...
I know, the whole time we were freaking...
He was like, I was like, man, you guys 15 seconds. I'm like, fuck, I gotta get out of here because I'm done.
I was too.
I'm not doing this again.
I had reached my breaking point.
Tony G, the legend killer.
I think I got most of them. There's a couple of them that,
Yeah, but you gotta remember three.
Hey! We're back! We're here, made it, except for one, a little bitch named Mahoney, my teammate, but it doesn't matter. I filled in with a more better all-star champion.
What's up? A little bit pissed off Caleb Mahoney is not here. He bitched out because he's a bitch. He's a fucking bitch that bitches out all the time. He's a bitching bitcher.
You know why Dan is so pissed off that Mahoney bitched out? Because a champion came to take his place. He's nervous. I'm already under his skin. I haven't even started talking shit yet.
I'm sore. I mean, I have a
hurt finger. Not really feeling it today. I'm gonna battle it out though, try and do my best.
What we got here, the picture is three rooks, three new guys, and three vets. So we'll see how it unfolds. So.
Yeah!
What'd you say?
A million of 50s music nowadays.
Woo! Woo! Woo!
You calm down, Chuck Liddell.
All right, so today's mission starts off. We're gonna have y'all blindfolded. Can you go pick those up, guys? All right, so you're gonna be blindfolded.
So I heard running, so I got excited, and then blindfolded, which made me unexcited.
We're gonna have you start at the top of that. You're gonna run to the bottom of it. There's a bunch of water balloons down there. Okay. In these water balloons is a little piece of plastic with a number on it. You gotta grab that water balloon, bring it back up to the top, pop that water balloon. You're gonna continue doing that until all the balloons are gone or until 2 minutes has passed up. And then whoever has the most points will win that challenge. Say Dan won the challenge, he would get the money, his whole team would win, and everybody from the red team would go to elimination.
You don't have to tell him what's gonna happen right now.
Go! Like being blindfolded made me dizzy, and I didn't know where people were at, and I didn't want to get an elbow in the face.
And I had a plan was to get all the balloons and move them to the side so everybody was searching around the ground, but they wouldn't be in the right area.
So first off the gate, I'm not doing too well. I think I stiff-armed and walking like this.
Do not have a number.
Because I popped the balloon and I couldn't find my number. Some of them don't have numbers.
I spent half the time of that mission searching for my first number that wasn't even in my balloon.
I just kind of drugged my feet and tried to kick them. Walked at a decent pace, not running. And I grabbed one, bit it open, squirted it on my nose, and had a hard time peeling the numbers out of the skin of the balloons, I don't know what you want to call it, out of the top balloons.
Tell me when to go!
Bray, you're here.
I just tried to take my time. I was more scared about running into people than anything else. Just tried to walk out, just yell, please don't hit me.
Every time I popped a balloon, it like explodes. So what I was doing, I was just ripping the tops off of them, letting all the water out, and I just put the whole balloon in my pocket. That way, if the thing was in there, it didn't come flying out.
Right here. Right here. Kai!
Watch out for the box. Where are you looking? Where are you looking? All right. That's it.
That's it.
That's it.
Let's see these numbers, kids. What you got?
What do we got?
10!
10 points. Woo!
Tony G comes out of nowhere with a 10, kicking butt and taking namers.
You have 7, 8, 9, 12.
That's 13.
13?
No, 12.
12. Dan is the winner.
Suck it!
Gonna use something a little bit safer. Look at that, it's a fucking gash. It's talking to you.
Hello, my name is Jordan.
Actually, I probably got just as many balloons as everybody else, but none of mine had numbers in them except for the 110. And I thought that would have gave me a chance, but who knew 4 threes was better than a 10. I did it.
Yeah, it just feels great to send one of the, what are there, 2 champions on that team? 3? Is Tony a champion? 3 champions on that team. And I just took one of them now, the rookie.
I'm already gonna kill him. I spit from somebody really hard to hit. I'm just walking like
this. Now I gotta go to elimination already. One challenge, I'm already in elimination. And I don't want my team to go home because I like us.
Who would you like to see go home?
Mahoney.
Who would you like to see go home if it wasn't you?
Either one. Just not me, I guess.
Who would you like to win this elimination here?
I would say Tony. I feel like Tony fucking, he actually wants to win this thing. Cameron don't give 2 fucks about life in general, so. I mean, I don't either, but I like to win this thing for you people.
How about this elimination? Who are you hoping loses?
Cameron.
I mean, it could be anybody's game.
And I don't know what this next challenge is going to be, but I hope I don't have to be blindfolded for it, because I don't like that.
You're going to be blindfolded for it.
Fuck.
Chicken butt.
Oh.
It's the person that's going to be doing this is going to be here, all right? And then they're going to be blindfolded. I know how you guys love blindfold, so keep it going. And they're going to go to this, they're going to have like, let's say, 30 seconds to go to this bowl. Get some wine punch in their mouth, and you're gonna go back to this cup, spit it in the cup. Well, whoever has the least after the 30 seconds will be the one going in.
Ooh. Is that a hickey on your neck?
I'm like the Jackie Chan of cobras. I can't speak a lick of English, but I'll beat your ass.
Okay. Scott was Jackie Chan last night, drunken mad.
Too soon.
Can
Too
I drink soon. Some of this wine punch?
Alright, that's enough, you asshole.
Let me try it.
45 seconds on the clock.
Get set, go.
Fuck. Right there. I'm right here. Here's the cup. I'm over here. Here we go. Here's the cup.
2.
That's on. It. Is it really how much you got?
Cam. That stands for Cam.
Go.
Butt shot.
Alright, I'm right here, I'm okay. Alright. Ah, I got one on my
shot. Honey, you're already safe.
Right, I'm right here. Okay, here you go.
You're already safe if you just want to call it a game.
Time's up.
Cameron's mark. You got Sony's mark.
Hey, you want a hand?
Alright, put some more in there.
Flip this over now.
You want that? You just got the cup.
Oh!
Scared.
And Jordan did get the most.
Cameron's, Tony's, Jordan's. Now there is a twist. The person with the most is going.
Just kidding.
Almost knocked you out.
Cameron,
I'm so glad you came out, but.
Thanks, Mahoney.
You do gotta go.
Yeah, Mahoney.
You do gotta go.
Go home.
Get a little bit fun, didn't you?
A little bit.
I love it.
Played like Mahoney at least.
I love that song.
Just a little bit!
I love it this much, actually, yeah. You're right.
Just a little bit. Ah, B!
Ow,
my thigh!
What is this, Facebook?
Remember you told me to hit upward earlier whenever you were saying that you were going to lose anyway.
I'm a sore loser.
You And then I guess we put showed Cisco that just because we're rooks don't mean we don't work the books.
I'm just so mad at that point of the night. I didn't get any pussy. He's still beautiful. It made me so mad.
I just wanted to make something beautiful ugly. That black guy was like...
No, he was not actually doing that.
Dude, he was doing some weird shit. He was like... He looked like Lil Richie, no joke, dude.
Did you see the white guy trying to do the arm thing? He's like...
No, dude, good. I was too...
Chicken butt.
I wanted to see how you guys feel about not blindfolds.
Yes! Sweet, no blindfolds on that, I'm down.
We have a little area set up.
Yeah, you better wear the blindfold
behind your back. And then there's going to be a football in the middle. You guys are going to start on the sides. When we say go, you run to try to get the football. Get it in your hand. You have to pick it up like this. Each time someone has it, I'm going to count it up in my head. I'm going to write it down as we're doing that.
Okay!
So where are all the other balls?
You can wear it if you want. It's probably not going to help you in the challenge. These are going to be out there. I know. Use them if you want. Well, I don't know how to do this. I'm not good with time. Do that one. You ready, Cameron?
I am on. Get set!
Kai said the first time you just kick it back, I pick it up, and then they just lay blocks for me.
I run up there, Kai kicks a fucking ball behind him. Completely took my goddamn strategy.
Fucking... Arms hurt me behind you, get a little nervous when you don't have a chance to brace yourself. It's a little bit scary of the feeling.
Like Tony G is all over the place with headbutts and shoulder throws.
But I don't know how about Tony just throwing himself around. It's fucking crazy.
Three, 2, 1.
It's disappointing. Two vets are getting thrown around like this.
They all both ran by me because I knew my technique, so I just kicked it forward, picked it up, grabbed it.
Kyle, man, every single time with that kick.
They're getting to the ball before us. I don't know if the ball is closer than, or if they're just faster enough, which I don't believe is true.
Because he is faster than his lightning out there.
When I hit my legs, I was scared because I could find myself some licks trying to brace myself with, I don't know, my ear or something.
Three, 2, 1.
Oh, I just kind of just. That's how. I'm an M.
It's just impossible. I felt like challenge was kind of lame because it was basically who gets the ball first wins, and we should have just done that because it just wasted my energy for the last minute running around.
Five, four, three, 2, 1.
Dan just won that. He had the most time with the ball.
The numbers definitely helped, but should have won the last challenge.
You know, the whole time I thought I'd pick a good team to mesh, and it looked like we were probably going to win out every challenge, and look, it's complete opposite. We won the first challenge, and after that, have been facing elimination every time.
I'm just frustrated because I just wore myself out doing nothing. I gotta go to elimination.
Part is our team's strategy for this game, and I think unknowingly for pretty much the whole challenge, and just not being selfish on the team, even though they're individual events. I think we decided to go ahead and split the money. Each one of us won individually.
Rooks in the books. Rooks in the book. We gotta figure something else to rhyme from Rooks. I couldn't.
Fuck, I gotta do what I gotta do. See you in elimination.
Oh! These guys are kicking each other's asses!
Four!
Sorry.
Here's the elimination. Here is Kole. Alright, Jorden and Tony are going to be starting over yonder at this green board on the tennis court.
Right?
Yeah. And then they're going to run over, they have to get over the net. They're going to run to the fence, climb the fence, go over on the other side of the fence, eat five marshmallows. When they're done eating these five marshmallows, they go back over the fence, over the net, touch the green board. Whoever does that first
is blindfold.
You ever been in a cage
match before? It wins. There's no blindfold.
You ever been in a cage match before?
But thanks for your help. Let's do it.
Nobody die on that fence.
On your mark.
Alright, we go, and I'm taking my time at first because I figure he's going to run real fast and waste all of his energy, and then I'll make up my time eating marshmallows. There's giant marshmallows. They're not just regular marshmallows. So I'm trying to take a little bite so I can swallow them fast. And I kept testing myself to see, like, start taking bigger bites and see if I could swallow it.
I got to the point where I was just pushing it with my tongue down my throat.
I need to see an empty mouth before you guys go, right?
Had to get into it fast. I felt like I was beating him out of nowhere. You know, he was on the last marshmallow. I was on the last marshmallow. He kind of caught up to me.
The last bite I took was a little too big because I about choked. Luckily, it's a marshmallow, so it just kind of disintegrated in my mouth, and then I swallowed it. I swallowed my last one, choked a little bit, showed it's got my mouth. He was filming. Didn't want to break the rules and just run, so I decided to wait there.
Spiky! Oh, it's a spiky!
When he jumped down, it shook the fence, I lost my footing, so I was done.
I'm the survivor of the team, the captain of the team. I've gone into three eliminations. Here I am in the finals for the championship.
The next final. You know, I gotta do whatever I can to win, alright? I'm not here for Jorden to win. I'm here for me to win. Alright, Brooke, so you know.
Hopefully I win, but if not, I feel like there's a new era anyway of champions that needs to be brought upon you guys. You guys don't need me anymore. You guys had me, and it was glorious, and we had a blast. Coming back trying to do things I know I shouldn't do. Who knows, I may Brett Favre it, you know? And maybe 40-year-olds in retirement come back, win the Super Bowl. Who knows? Who knows? We'll see. We'll find out next challenge. I feel like a deer frolicking through the forest when I jumped over that net. Cole's lanky-ass legs get caught on the net, he'd wipe out.
I'd front flip that thing. You want to see majestic. Hey, how much poop you got on your finger, Scott?
Little bit.
This is the second marshmallow challenge you guys have had to do.
Yeah, that was one of the puns. Yeah, you guys went head to head for the marshmallow challenge.
Is it a pun? Is that the correct?
It's not a pun at all.
I was going to say,
it's a pun. Look it up.
Ironic?
No.
It's a little ironic.
It's more ironic than it is a pun.
It's
a stream vicious challenge, not English class. Keep it simple out here, guys.
That's the crack of the joke.
I think that the challenge thing would be more coincidental than anything else.
Coincidental? Really? Just a bunch of,
I don't think irony is involved at all.
I think it's just a bunch of random.
It's not a coincidence because he planned it out. It's
what's funny is we're still on it.
Alright, there we go. You got it on film. We know what to do.
Dude, he's never going to put that 800 conversation on.
Cameron wins again.
I've got it now.
$60
anyway.
Ha! This change is going to hit me right in my face.
Get the fuck out of here!
Let me try it.
This is my third
King time. Kong Bundy!
Did you get that on camera?
You got some of them.
Remember when Kole did that? You look like a stud. You look like a fucking idiot.
I just did all
Yeah, Kole did a stack like that.
Who looks like getting nasty?
No!
Chicken foot.
In blindfold, you're gonna do three forward rolls and run to the other picnic table over here.
Okay.
Then you get to take your blindfold off.
Okay.
Run back to the first picnic table.
Stand.
Grab a marshmallow. Keep the marshmallow in your hand. Go across the monkey bars. Shoot your marshmallow in a basket. Get it, eat it.
What if I get tetanus from this?
Go around this sign, zigzag these trees, go to that pavilion, you'll do this math problem, and then you'll run back to the beginning, and that's the winner.
Y'all ready for this?
Alright, on your mark! Go!
I tried to do launching forward rolls. Rolled out like a Laura Croft from Tomb Raider. Take off my blindfold and I start fucking my shit up, man. Look at this.
The ground is hard.
Right over here! Right over here!
Ran, couldn't find the table she's saying here, I know, but just couldn't find it. Took my blindfold off. Jorden was already halfway done crawling. So I hauled balls crawling.
Out of nowhere I hear fucking the stampede behind me. It's just Kai. He's fucking booking it like a crazy motherfucker. I don't know how the hell he did that.
I got to the monkey bars first. Jumped with the marshmallow in my hand and dropped it because I didn't really know how to carry it.
I go across the monkey bars, head up, missed my first shot like a dummy, tried to do a little finger roll. We kind of have a little scuffle there for the marshmallow because mine was underneath him, so I'm sitting there trying to reach between his legs like I'm giving him a hand ski or something.
So we both started running. It's hard to run with it in our mouth, chewing, trying to swallow at the same time.
Weave through those trees and swallow. Everything almost came up. Hardee's, marshmallow. I did not expect that. That was a fucking long ass problem. It was almost the whole length of the fucking paper. Single digits and double digits. Just a beautiful moment after that. I just felt the wind pick up. It almost glided me to the victory.
Fuck! Said it 1,000 times, I'll say it again. Children, learn your math because it becomes important in later activities. Can I give up? Did you want?
Yep.
Feels good. Who said they were gonna do it, baby? Who said they were gonna do it? I wish I did better in school. I'm still in school. Fuck me.
Can't stop. Can't fucking stop.
God. I wish I knew Matt!
Kai, who?
I was really looking forward to winning, too.
Jorden Hamblin. I've come to cast. What the hell, Jorden? They're not gonna know.
has been eliminated.
Jordan Hamlin? I'm gonna have sex with that kid.
Let's give Jordan a little applaud. He's a dinosaur. He needed to get one more. About the end of his time.
3 out of 4 were rooks. I guess the rooks won if you really size it up there.
No.
Look at it.
Beautiful.
Sick, man. And once I realized I had to eat my marshmallow, that's kind of where I gave up hope. Got to about the tree, took a bite, realized what a mistake it was, and then I kind of noticed no one was looking, so I shucked to the side. And then you caught me, you dirty son of a gun. All hope was lost in it anyway, because let's be honest with ourselves, it took 2 years of math. Alright, this just wasn't happening.
Bye to the ladies all out there, my followers, you know. I'll call you later, junior high girls.
It's home. It's home now. It's finally where it belongs. 5-time champion. 4/1. You add those together. It's 5. If you want to count the half, which I don't really like to do, but 5.5-time champion. I love you, fans. You love me. I am this challenge.